And so, were they able to eventually get the full data sets to train on? How did that work out?
Yes. So the in this per in this these particular in this context, I think because of GDPR compliance related issues, etc., we couldn't make that have we couldn't have the data available in the dev environment. But what we managed to do is to separate out the training run process from the code build process. So it kind of hampered a little bit because the error signals are a little bit delayed. But what we the way we did is every time the you have to check in the code for your training run to run. There is no notebook-based experimentation which is possible. But as soon as we check in the code, which is which goes into your it triggers your pipeline, and once this pipeline is triggered, your model build process starts. And once the model build process is complete, you get to see the reports in real time. Even if you are not seeing the data in real time, you get to see the metrics and other information in real time. And we created a separate environment which is allowed for certain users, users who can conform to the rules and regulations as per GDPR. And they could actually do live work with the data. So basically, we split it into two different components. In one piece, the training code writing and the training process are a little different, are separated out. And in one environment, you can do both of them kind of simultaneously.